we're in the midst of a global environment that really is very, very different than it was 5 years ago, 10 years ago, and certainly even a year ago. We live in a global context that is really a dichotomy, in my view, one with opportunities offered through technology advancement that help us live our lives better, longer, and certainly differently. But we also live in a world today that's insecure, that has extreme poverty, and we have many, many of our humankind around the world living in very, very dire and desperate circumstances. If you're following international news today at all, you can see just how much the world has changed, just even in the last year. We have the continued surge of the Islamic State, the massive influx of refugees and migrants into Europe as a result of the conflicts in Libya and in Syria. You have the same happening within Africa today, East and West Africa, tons of refugees, and also a lot of issues with climate change, disaster, and drought. You have the ongoing tensions in the Ukraine. We have the conflicts going on still in Iraq and Afghanistan. And then you also have this terrorism belt that I've been calling the Sahel Extreme Terrorism Belt that runs from Tunisia through Nigeria, Niger, Chad, and all the way over to the east coast of the continent. However, despite all of those challenges, I think that there are new partners out there, politically, culturally, and economically, with whom the U.S. can further engage for the long term, despite these very turbulent times that I've highlighted.